Modern life relies on vast amounts of energy, but 80% of the world's power comes from fossil fuels. Energy use accounts for almost 75% of global greenhouse gas emissions. Global energy demand is projected to more than double by 2050 as the population grows and economies shift. We understand today that humanity's use of fossil fuels is severely damaging our environment. Fossil fuels cause local pollution where they are produced and used, and their ongoing use is causing lasting harm to the climate of our entire planet. Nonetheless, meaningfully changing our ways has been very difficult. Amid growing global energy demand and rising carbon dioxide emissions, the majority of Americans say the United States should prioritize the development of renewable energy sources, such as wind and solar, and take steps toward the country becoming carbon neutral by the year 2050. This makes way for a transition to clean energy essential to meeting global climate goals. A lot of focus is put on generating cleaner energy for a sustainable future. That's only one piece of the puzzle. What if we could dramatically reduce our energy consumption just by changing the way we build our communities or operate our transportation? Imagine any mode of transportation, such as a city bus, working because of the energy used is harnessed from algae, a common microorganism formerly known as cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria are among the most abundant organisms on our planet. 2 billion years ago, they were the first organisms to use photosynthesis and helped create Earth's oxygen-rich atmosphere. Cyanobacteria and their pervasiveness in recreational and drinking water sources are a significant challenge for water utilities worldwide. But what if we could use cyanobacteria as a source of energy?
Cyanobacteria completes both photosynthesis and respiration processes. While undergoing photosynthesis, the microorganism produces electrons, some of which are exported outside the cell. An electric current is then generated as a result of the movement of electrons between atoms. While harnessing electricity from a single-celled organism might sound impossible, it has been experimentally proven by researchers at multiple higher institutions around the world.
Our vision is for the byproducts of this natural operation to be taken advantage of. We're attempting to use developing technology of panels containing cyanobacteria to exploit the electricity produced through photosynthesis. Taking inspiration from the fully electric bus routes at Florida State University, we decided to look into upgrading the community transportation of an urban area. Our goal for this innovation is to improve infrastructure by producing usable energy locally. The panels would sit on top of the bus. The frame and outer structure of the bus would remain the same for safety reasons. The average amount of space that can be utilized by panels on the top of the bus is about 12 meters by 2.5 meters, or 30 square meters. Based on data collected by green fluidics of a prototyped algae panel, the bus itself could feasibly be responsible for bringing in up to 9,840 kilowatt hours per year. In this case, we're looking to change the image of city buses. On average, electric bus energy consumption is about 2 kilowatt hours per kilometer. That being said, our bus should be able to travel about 5,000 kilometers, or over 3,000 miles, just on the electricity generated by the panel on top of the bus. We'd have a battery on the bus that is charged by the panels, and an additional source of energy would be the green bus stop. The shelter that you would typically find at a bus stop would be made of our cyanobacteria panels. Each bus would have a scheduled stop so the electricity charged into the battery of the bus stop could be quickly transferred to the battery of the actual bus. Based on the average size of a regular bus stop, one stop could generate over 8,000 kilowatt hours per year. Like many other renewable resources, algae or cyanobacteria energy is an investment. Returns on the investment are likely to take an extended period of time. There's not much information available about the expenses required to create the panels that sit on the tops of the buses and access walls of the bus stops. However, we can assume the price of manufacturing would likely be similar to that of solar panels once the technology is more developed and refined. Depending on the amount of usage of the solar panels on homes, they can take on average 8 years to create a profit. Since we're utilizing our cyanobacteria panels for more than a typical home would, we might assume that our return would occur faster than that of home solar panels. To estimate what consumers would pay for cyanobacteria energy versus fossil fuel energy, we can look at the current difference in price between electric and fossil fuel energy. Our bus design will ideally have a similar price point to current electric buses. Looking at Los Angeles DOT data, we find that electric buses operate at an average of 46 cents per mile, including maintenance, while buses that use natural gas operate at an average of $1.27 per mile. Reducing the amount of energy that has to be taken from a charging station in turn reduces the amount of stress on the electricity grid. Our idea promotes changing infrastructure by transitioning into a whole new method of energy production.
We can find a new way to improve infrastructure that not only benefits humans but the natural environment as well. As demonstrated, biomimicry can be used as an integrative architectural design component to create complete unity between the building, the users, and the environment. That is what we aim to do. Innovation inspired